Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly readings for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, and Rising. If you guys are interested in any of the services that I provide or in any private consultations, definitely look at the description box below. You'll be able to find my contact information on there. So let's get with your reading, Capricorns. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for the month of October 2017. Spirit, what are the messages for Capricorns for the month of October 2017? What are the messages for Capricorns for the month of October 2017? Okay, I think this is going to be, well, one more. Okay. Here we go. All right, Capricorns, you start, whoa, Cappies, what's going on? These cards just flew out. All right, so you have the Ten of Cups, the Magician card, the Lovers, the Nine of Coins, the Six of Cups in reverse, the Three of Swords in reverse, the King of Wands in reverse. Wow, you guys have a lot of reverse cards, and I don't really do reversals. I don't really do reversals because Spirit will let me know if they are reversed energy or not. But for some reason, when I was shuffling, I guess they just wanted to come out reverse. Wow. Okay. All right. So you have the Knight of Cups as a general energy for the month of October. So Capricorns, love and partnerships is going to be very important for you guys for this month of October, for sure. Now you guys are starting off the month with the Ten of Cups. The Ten of Cups is emotional fulfillment, but also speaks about family dynamics. You're going towards the Magician. So you're being able to manifest the love or the connection you've been wanting for quite a while, Capricorns. Now for those of you guys that are single, you're no longer going to be single. The reason I say that is the Nine of Pentacles is in reverse. And this is a singlehood card. And because it's right next to the Lovers card, there's definitely a union or a partnership coming for you guys. So this could be in regards to business and finances. This can also have to do, obviously, with relationships. Now, for some of you guys, it may resonate more with relationships because you are starting off the month with the energies of the Knight of Cups, which is love messages, love communication, people offering you opportunities or offering you their love. So again, the Lovers is definitely looking towards the reversal of the singlehood card because it is in reverse position. So you will no longer be single for you, Capricorns. Now you guys may be dealing with the Gemini. I definitely see a Sagittarius here. I see a Leo. Fire signs, so fire signs is a Leo and Aries or a Sagittarius, or water signs for some. Water sign could be a Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio. So again, it could basically be any sign because I definitely do see all the elements here. Now, moving on from this partnership or this connection that you've manifested or that you've brought to yourself, you have the Six of Cups in reverse. So the Six of Cups is, you know, the Ten of Cups is crowning the Six of Cups, and the Six of Cups is in reverse. So there is a taking away from, there's a taking away from a friendship. So you're pulling away from a friendship, something that's been building for quite a while. Perhaps you recently found out that maybe a friend or someone you've been very close to actually has emotional ties to you, emotional feelings for you, and it's making you feel a little bit uneasy. And that's the reason why you're pulling away from that. Now, the Temperance in reverse is the opposite of that, which is balance. So I feel that this threw you off, Capricorns, the knowing that they're interested in you, perhaps scared some of you guys. I know Capricorns tend to be very practical. So in regards to practicality, if this is a friend, someone you've built a friendship for a long time, it could be scary for you guys, and you may retract by pulling away from that person only to get some type of clarity or wanting to figure out if you want to move forward or not. Now, you have the Magician here with the Three of Swords. So a lot of you Capricorns are dealing with the healing energy of that of betrayal and hurt. Because it is in reverse, you guys have already experienced this, or you guys are surpassing the betrayal or the cheating, whatever it could have been, and pulling away from that. Now, you do have the Sun here, and the Sun card in reverse speaks about being ungrateful or not being thankful for the things that you have been given. Now, for a lot of you Capricorns, I know that the beginning of the year, there was some type of difficulty, but then moving towards the middle of the year, you guys have been more either abundant or starting to find more stability. Try the best you can to remember what it was when you were dealing with difficulties, how you felt, and try the best you can to be grateful and thankful for what the universe is bringing to you. The Sun card in reverse is definitely talking about taking some things for granted. It could be that you're taking family members for granted. It could be that you're taking your partner for granted. For others, it could be the fact that you're not really wanting, like you've already been healed. Now, this is talking to those of you who have been single for quite a while. You have been single for quite a while with this Three of Swords. You've already surpassed the hurt. The dealing with, again, like I said, the betrayal, cheating, you've already surpassed this. At this point, it's you the one that's fearing commitment. It's you the one that's fearing connection or being able to jump into a relationship, because the Sun card is all about illumination, but also speaks about partnerships and blessings. Because it is in reverse, it's definitely talking, and then you know, it's right underneath the Three of Swords. It's like the Three of Swords, the swords came out of your heart already. You're either going through the process of healing or you have already been completely healed. But now it's you, the one that either is not being thankful or you're fearing commitment at the present time, and it probably has to do from the past. So try the best you can to understand, Capricorn. At the end of the day, not everyone is the same. Okay, not all women are the same, not all men are the same. Everyone is unique in their own special way. And you cannot judge people or different people based on what people from the past have done to you. You need to move forward. Life is all about seasons and progression. So don't stop or don't maintain yourself, in the singlehood type of energy just because you fear commitment or because you fear you might end up getting hurt. Because ultimately, you're missing out on something that could be grand or could be great for you, and vice versa. Now, you may be dealing with a fire sign. Like I said, the Lover's card right underneath it is the King of Wands. But this connection with this fire sign is the King of Wands in the reverse position is a person that is very not the commitment type, okay? They're definitely very flirtatious. They're definitely very sexual. This could be a person that is very promiscuous. It could be both male or female. Doesn't matter. It's a general reading. So again, I feel that this person is interested in you. And they're wanting to show how interested they are in you. But for Capricorns specifically, I don't suggest you going for a fire sign that is of the promiscuous type. Because Capricorns, at the end of the day, you guys are represented as the devil. You may be very connected to addictions, to sex, to everything that has to do with the mundane and the material. Because that's what we're ruled by. But ultimately, when it comes to relationships, you need stability. Or you need to know that you're going towards a goal, towards an achievement, towards commitment. And this fire sign in reverse, they're definitely interested in you. And perhaps they are interested in you because for some of them, or for some of you guys, are coming off to them as a challenge. So that could be very enticing. This could be very exciting for them. But ultimately, they do have promiscuous tendencies. So again, this could be a person that you're dealing with or have been dealing with for quite a while that, you know, comes in and out of your life whenever they want. So at the end of the day, you have to come to the realization you can't change their nature. You can't change who they are. So you either commit to that of accepting them for who they are, or move on from that and release yourself from that type of energy. Now, you do have the Five of Cups here, and the Five of Cups is in the reverse position. So the Five of Cups is missing someone. With the opposite of this, I feel that this could have been also a fire sign, could have been a person from your past, and you're currently dealing with either a Leo, a Sagittarius, or a water sign, because you do have water signs here. And this fire sign is someone you left from the past. Because it is in the reverse position, now that you're no longer missing them or craving them or thinking of them, it's like they're pulling or gravitating more towards you. Perhaps, again, like I spoke about a challenge, you're becoming a challenge. Perhaps they thought they had you very reassured, and now you're putting some type of resistance. So they're wanting to feel like to chase you. So be very mindful about that, Capricorn. Now, at the end of the month, you do have the Nine of Wands in reverse. So the Nine of Wands is going through the ringer, being exposed to many difficulties, but in the reverse position, those obstacles are no longer there for you, Capricorn. You're moving forward. You're moving on. The Nine of Coins in the reversal can also represent, again, like I said, loss of money or income, but I feel that this is more to do with relationship-wise, no longer being single. But in regards to finances and business, I actually see you growing your business, or I see you guys being able to make more money than you usually do. The Nine of Wands, there's no more blockages there to stop you from moving forward. The Four of Swords could be a representation of taking some time apart. So again, like I said, for some of you guys, it's that you actually detach yourself or pulled away from this fire sign. And there's currently time for you to be alone or time for you to heal. But I think this Four of Swords is taking on the energies of you guys being very focused and very determined. You have a goal, you've set a goal, and you're moving towards that goal. So all in all, this is a good reading for you, Capricorns, in regards to finances and money. When it comes to relationships, again, like I said, try the best you can to stay away from this fire sign. But other than that, if it's a water sign, it could be that the water sign, there was a detachment. Either you pulled away from the water sign or they pulled away from you. But it's actually going to help you guys, because it's going to bring clarity to the relationship and to both of you. Finally, them reaching out to you, giving you this offer of love, or this offer of, yes, I miss you. Yes, I want to be with you. And again, like I said, going from the beginning stages to something more serious in regards to relationships, okay? Let me see. Now, for those of you guys that are currently in a relationship, in a committed relationship, again, like I said, I feel that there's been a lot of energy. You have a lot of energy here, but more than anything, what the message here is ultimately, don't be ungrateful. If you've been through difficulties when it comes to finances, when it comes to business, perhaps some of you guys were hit hard in regards to losing a job, and currently you started working again, Capricorns. Try the best you can to let your partner know that you appreciate all the effort and all the support they've given you. Don't be ungrateful, because at the end of the day, I feel that there's someone that may end up getting hurt, or may be end up feeling like you just take them for granted, you're not reciprocating, or you're not putting the effort. So try the best you can to, again, like I said, give thanks and be grateful for the opportunities, for the people around you, and for having a loving and supportive type of partner with you, okay? So I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Like, comment, share my videos. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, definitely subscribe, and we will see from each other in the middle of the month.